Yeah, thank you, Salo. So as Brenda explained in the structural health analysis, which she performs, a lot of information is gathered, and we have defined a three-year project, program actually, to develop an instrumentation which captures this information and also adds value to that. What I'm going to present today is a mock-up demonstration. We are 6 months into this three-year program, and we have some mock-ups which we can present the results and also get a lot of feedback on the results. Now, with me, I mean ourselves from TNO, but also our colleague experts from Deltares and COB, and I also mean Rijkswaterstaat, who assigned us this task to do, for which we are, of course, very grateful. Brenda already explained that the actual aim of the structural health analysis, but also of the instrumentations we are building, is to better scope and plan a tunnel renovation. So what we are doing is getting information readily available from different projects, from different tunnels, readily available for other tunnels and other tunnel managers, in such a way that the risk and cost going to a tunnel renovation in the time to a tunnel renovation, but also the renovation itself, the scoping of it, and even after that, the asset management after the renovation, that these costs and risks are reduced. So we are heavily pushing on the information pillar of asset management, but we are not forgetting the engineering, and we are also not forgetting management, which is also important, which will be addressed in my presentation in the coming minutes. So what are these instruments which we are developing, and what is their added value? We are doing four instruments. The first one is a knowledge retainment system, which is intended to be like a single point of entry for a tunnel manager to come to all the information from the structural health analysis, but also from other sources, and representing this information in an intuitive way to the tunnel manager, so that the way it's presented is in a way that the tunnel manager understands it and can easily use it. So that's the first system, the knowledge retainment system. Then the second instrument is a monitoring strategy template. Monitoring can play an important part in predicting this moment in which to plan a tunnel renovation. But monitoring is, but to do that, you need to define a monitoring strategy which gives you fit for purpose information for the specific tunnel which you are planning, which is involved, but also as per will wants to have a uniform monitoring program if this concerns one degradation mechanism. The third instrument is the instrument which adds value to this information by using performance modeling. If you can model your performance and with which you can predict your performance, like settlements, etc., then you can really optimize this planning in time and also optimize the scope of the renovation in a better way. And the fourth instrument, if you have all this information available, then it would be a shame not to look into the opportunities of artificial intelligence, and a topic which heavy investments are put in Europe, but also in the United States, from which we expect a lot. So it's also good to see whether these new technologies can add value to all this information which is now readily available. So now I will introduce shortly these four instruments to you, and I will end with a call for action for you to help us further develop these instruments in such a way that it is more value for you as a tunnel manager. So the knowledge retainment system, the first instrument. As you know, in the structural health analysis, but also in tunnel management, a lot of information is available on what is it, what is the kind of a tunnel, so what is the tunnel decomposition, what elements are in it, what are the associated failure mechanisms and the risks of this tunnel, what kind of investigations or inspections or monitoring has already been performed, and what information is given by that, and also solutions and maintenance plans are available. Now, all this information, all this data, all this knowledge is, of course, structured. There is a structure in it. It's not. It's all related, and with this structure is also the intuitive entry for a tunnel manager to find this information, also for tunnels which he has no experience with. So what we did is we looked, we analyzed this information from a knowledge modeling, semantic knowledge modeling way. We analyzed it to develop this structure, and we modeled that structure behind this information. And which you can see here in this slide. So this is only a break slide, so don't read it. And being able to model this knowledge, you can then also implement it in a semantic knowledge system. In this case, it's a semantic wiki, which we use for our mockup. And with this semantic wiki, you can intuitively retrieve this information. Now, I'll show you some screen dumps of this tool. So here you can look for your problem, being, for instance, leakage around an immersion joint through cracks in concrete. You can see, in the drag tunnel, there this has happened. And also there has been a reliability assessment done in this tunnel for this aspect of that tunnel. And so you can also get that information readily available, and besides that, you can also be guided to other information sources from being it your own system or other systems, which is appropriate for the example which you are studying at hand. So it's not so, and this latter functionality is this single point of entry from which. You are guided through the system to all other relevant information sources. Now, the second instrument which we're developing is a monitoring strategy template. Now, monitoring is actually a very complicated technology, which maybe we do not realize. Monitoring not only combines several difficult technologies like sensoring, data science, measurement principles, civil engineering, but proper monitoring also requires that you have a very, very thorough understanding of the demands. Why are you monitoring? What is the risk you're monitoring? And which measures are actually available to counteract this risk? Because if you're monitoring a risk which there is no measure available to counteract it, what's the use of monitoring? And this our monitoring template guides you from this demand perspective, guides you in several steps here through these indicated here through these styles, from the risk to actually the measurements techniques and the data collection techniques, which are the most appropriate techniques to help you with the problem which you have at hand in the tunnel. So this template is a template, so it helps guide you through it. So there is quite some background to this template, but it is not a prescription. So it guides you, but it is not a prescription. Then the third instrument which we are building, that is the data enhanced performance prediction. So you have all this information, now you also have monitoring, so you can, so you know time dependencies of the processes at hand, then you are able to also to do a performance prediction based also on data. And to do that, what do you need? Well, you need to have a predictive model which predicts your performance. And that in our case is based on physics, because we believe that only data has not enough information to give you a more accurate prediction. So you need this predictive physics-based model. You need the relevant monitoring data, and you need, for instance, the reliability-based approach. Because if you predict into the to the future, then you need to accept that you have to express results in a probability, because nobody knows the future, of course. Now, we developed such a system, and we or first edition of such a system, and we did a case study with that being the Drecht Tunnel, which is a tunnel from 1977. It consists of three immersed tunnel elements, six segments each, and during the course of time, one leakage was reported in the dilatation joint, and that was already 18 years ago, but we used this tunnel because we had a lot of information on it. Now, what did we, more precisely, what did we model? So we modeled time-dependent settlements. We looked at the global deformation of these tunnel segments, and our the poor performance which we predicted was the deformation capacity of those joints. Now, in the bottom part of this slide, you see on the left-hand side the tunnel. In the middle, you see on the lower part, you see the model which we built on the more upper part. You see the measurements which were incorporated into the system. And on the right-hand side, you see two results. One is the result of the failure of the shear key, the capacity of the, so it's a failure probability. And you see that the red line is when you only use the model, and the blue line is when you use data and model, and you see quite some reduction in the failure probability. Now that this tool is not the answer to everything is shown in the bottom graph for the failure of the GINA profile in the dilatation joints. Here you see no improvement, which is basically because this is a very, very rigid, robust construction. Finally, the fourth instrument, which is actually not really an instrument at the moment, it was an inventory on the possibilities of using artificial intelligence to help improve decision making in tunnel management. And we saw that there are possibilities to detect problems earlier in tunnels and to reduce risk and downtimes of tunnels by using all this data, which is acquired in structural, for instance, in the structural health analysis. We looked into several machine learning and data analytics technologies. And some opportunities to improve and to get more added value from this information have been identified. For instance, crack detection and leakage seem promising applications for acoustic emission for artificial intelligence to add value to this information, which is already gathered, of course. Then I come to my last slide. As I said, we are pushing heavily on the information side of asset management, but it needs to be used in the management in the management side of asset management. There, this information is used. We are scientists, so we have some managers, but we are scientists. We certainly don't have asset managers, so we need the help of you as a tunnel manager to develop these instruments in such a way that they are useful for you. So. Please, if you want to help us to build these fit-for-purpose instruments, please join us. And one opportunity is, for instance, the CUB Tunnel Day on the 28th of January next year. If you want to join that, please contact us beforehand, because we need to arrange things to do that. You can also come into our TNO booth, digital booth here in the conference, or you can also email me or us if you want to be involved with it in this. And actually, we need you. My last slide is a big thank you to Rijkswaterstaat for sponsoring and supporting this development. Thank you.
Well, Willy, thank you for your presentation on the information model.
Yeah.
I don't see any questions on the platform, but
is it working?
Please keep your questions to the mobile phone of Ellen van Eyck. She's over there, and she hands over the questions to me. That works. I have two questions, with thanks to Jenny van Daverveld, one of the participants. And she's asking, knowing that data acquisition and data management is a very important discipline, and not always all information is available, but have you looked in different countries on which data is gathered? Do tunnel owners in different countries gather different information, or do they have the same fixed set of data that they want to gather?
Yeah, of course, that's a good question. As I said, we are 6 months now into this development, and at the moment we actually only looked at Dutch practice. Mm-hmm. So we didn't look abroad, and hence also my call for action, also from people, especially from people in other European countries.
And with this, please
help us. Yeah.
And with this 6 months of experience, do you already have an idea on what is the minimum set of information that you require, for instance, for a cut and cover tunnel or an immersed tunnel or a bore tunnel?
Well, the point is that there is the point is that what the instrumentation wants to do is to get the maximum out of the information which by making it easily accessible. So it doesn't take you a day to look into the information of another tunnel. It takes you 5 minutes, and it is made easy for you to do that. So that's the first thing. So to get the maximum of what is there.
Yeah.
Second is the question is more related to that, is to, how can we add value to that information?
Yeah.
For instance, by using the data enhanced modeling.
Yeah.
And it's a good question. We are not as far as that we can assess what is the minimum set of information you need. It was also clear in the examples. So that's one of the things which we need to address is for which set of information are these tools, especially the tools which add value, are these appropriate? Are these can these be used?
Yeah. Okay. There is also a question about the model, and there is still 1 minute left. People can shift. The question was, how do you manage detailed information and rather general information? Does the model fulfill all the different types of information that you have? How does it work?
I'm not sure.
The question was actually rather on the table was, can you gather detailed information, and how can you combine that with general information?
Yeah. So as in the knowledge retainment system has this option that it forms a single point of entry. So there you get the more general information in a certain way, but it then can lead you through a link to a different system, to a different management system, in which this detailed information, which is not useful to be seen when you are doing a query in the knowledge retainment system, but which you can access through the knowledge retainment system in which we are developing.
Okay.
Is that an answer to your question?
I think so. I will do for it. Because we need to prepare for the last lecture. We have now in our toolbox a structural health analysis. We have information which is very important to have. And gathering this information is one thing. But managing it with a model is important to make predictions. So that's what you explained. The last lecture is from Arnoud Opdenkelder, and he is discussing when you prepare a refurbishment project, what should be in your toolkit, what type of contracts are suitable to manage a refurbishment project. Arnoud, please start your presentation.